for you, class 11, and this is the first time you are learning accounting, right? So this is the first accounts for you. Till 10th you didn't study accounting, so first time you are learning accounting. I have decided to take NCERT syllabus, all the chapters and all the topics we will be uploading in YouTube. You can check it out whenever you want, whichever topic is tough for you, that we can do here. Okay, fine. So since first time you are watching, I'm going slowly in the starting terms and all. Slowly we will increase fast. Okay, starting I will be going little bit slowly. After that, slowly I will increase the speed, then we can keep up with the time. Got it? First time if you are watching my videos, so please subscribe them, like them and share to more and more students. Clear? So now first let us know accounting. What is accounting? Why do we need accounting? We are having maths, we are having other subjects. Why do we need accounts? What is accounts? What is the use of accounts? First let us know that one. Since you choose this commerce field, I think you might be interested in business, right? In future you are planning to do the business, or you want to take care of your parents' business or something like that, right? You are interested in terms of money, monetary terms, you are so much interested, right? So to keep them in order, we are doing accounts. So what do you mean by to keep them in order? That is the question, right? Why to keep, what is the keeping in order? When you are doing the business, it is not one, there will be number of transactions. There will be number of transactions. I am asking you one question. You are having one old, one mobile. You purchased one more new mobile. So what will you do with the old mobile? You will give to friends, that now you keep aside. Okay. Come to the monetary things. You purchased one new mobile. So that old one, you put in OLX and you sold it off. Okay. You put in OLX and you sold it off. Is it called business? Is it called business? No, only one-time transaction will not be called as business. Okay, even in business studies also the same topic can be useful for you. In one-time transactions will not be called as business. Business in the sense, it is a continuous process. It keep on going. Continuous. Always it will be continuing. Every year, every day you are doing the same kind of transactions. So, and it should be in monetary transactions. When you have done in the monetary transactions, will you leave that like that only? Won't you remember what and all happened? You have to keep an order, right? Morning you have purchased 10,000 worth stock, and after that on that day itself you sold 8,000, and again next day you purchased 5,000 units of items. Will you sell to the same person? No, you will sell to the different kind of people. So when these many kind of transactions are happening, you have to keep them in order to know what happened exactly in your business. To keep them in a systematic order is called as accounting. Okay, how do we keep them in the systematic order? That we will learn. First let us know what is the meaning of accounting. Now what we learn, why we need accounts, that you learn, correct? Now we will know what is the meaning of accounting. It is an art of recording whatever happened, whatever transaction happened, that first you have to record. Okay, you purchased something, you have to record, yes, we have purchased, and after that immediately you sold to someone, or you have take, you have done some sales. Earlier you have done the sales, they returned the goods. Sometimes you would have paid the salary, you paid some delivery expenses. So you have to record first the transactions, recording the transactions, that we will do. And after that you have to classify them. What is the difference between recording and classifying? First you just entered the transaction, and after that we are classifying them in such a way, all the purchases we will write in one place, all the sales in one place. Okay, like that we will be classifying. Got it? Or else all the asset transactions in one place we will keep. Assets in the sense, what is that exact meaning? When we are discussing about the basic terms, that I will explain. So I am not using any technical words now. Okay, all the classification we have to do. And after that, summarizing them. You are working out on that, what happened exactly. You are gonna find out. Okay, that is summarizing. How? However I want, you can't do. In a single paper I will take down everything, I will write in a paper, ma'am, it is enough. No, it will not help out. You have to follow the rules. What are rules? Yes, that also we will be learning in the next videos. Okay, in a proper manner we are showing them. Okay, what you are entering? Yeah, two people came. Simply they just visited the shop and went off. Is that a transaction? That is not at all called as transaction. The transaction must be in monetary terms. It must be dealing with money. Simply came and went off, it doesn't mean monetary transaction. Let it be, yes, they have purchased now, they will be paying later. But that is still monetary transaction only. Either credit or cash, that we will discuss later. But in that, money is involved. So, what is this? It is an art of first recording the transactions. Then we will be classifying them and we are summarizing them in a significant manner in the terms of money. Got it? That is the meaning of accounting. All of you clear? Okay, when we are using the accounts, what are the characteristics you can take up? First one is reliability. That means so many people, not only the management or owners of the business, the people who are utilizing, it may be staff, it may be who have given the credit to the business, whoever invested in the business, everyone will be dependent on these accounts only. Accounts of the business only, they totally depended. So, reliability must be there. How the reliability will be there? When I have done transactions of one person, okay, if I am taking Ranjit, I have taken one customer of mine, I have done 10 transactions with him. That means he purchased sometimes, he purchased on first day, he purchased 10,000 worth. Okay. And again on third, he said there was some damage, so he returned 2,000. Next day he came on fifth and he paid to me 6,000. Now what is the balance from him? How much I should get? 2,000 rupees. 6,000 already he paid to me. 2,000 he returned to me. So total how much he should pay to me now? 2,000 is the balance. Before paying that itself, on 7th again he purchased some goods with 6,000. If I write down like this, when I am classifying them, if I commit a mistake, obviously how much he is supposed to pay me or how much is the balance between us, there will be a question mark. So, when people are dependent on this, there should not be any mistake. You must follow what are the main concepts need to be entered. Okay, you have to follow the concept and then you have to prepare the accounts. Okay, so people are relying on that. You should not commit any kind of mistakes. So, the accounts must have reliability. Understood? Why we need to rely on that, or in which way we are relying, how it will be affecting. Got it? So, reliability must be there. Next, relevance. The relevance data only must be there. That means it should be in the terms of monetary. Only in the terms of money transactions only you have to enter. Got it? That is relevance data. Next, classified data. Whatever data is there. Here I have given such a big. In between, not only Ranjit, I am having so many customers. Only with one person, we will not do the business, right? In between, Akshaya will come, Kiran will come, Arun will come. So many people will be coming, right? So, I have to classify. Only for Ranjit, I have to prepare separate. Only for Akshaya, I have to prepare separate account. I have to classify the data. Whenever I want to see how much Akshaya should pay me. Or else, what is the due between Akshaya and me? Then I should find out immediately. I should not search so many pages or so many datas. Okay. So it must be classified data. This is one more characteristic. Next, understandability. The next one is understandability. Whatever you have prepared, it must be in the position of understanding. Why? Because the people who are taking decisions on the business, if they don't understand what is the situation of the business, then they can't take any kind of decisions. Got it? Next one is comparability. Comparability. Why we need to do comparison? Why we need to do comparison? The reason why we need to do the comparison, last year, 2 years before I have started my business. 2019 I have started business or 2018 I have started business. In these 3 years, what happened? I must know, right? Last year I have committed mistake with this person. I have given him more credit, so he ran away. I didn't get back. If I see the accounts, then only I will be knowing. Ma'am, one person ran away. Why don't I remember? Sure, I will be remember. One person you will remember. How many people you will remember? That is not possible, right? So, comparability will be there. That is the reason we will be preparing the accounts. Every year, you can cross-verify where you committed the mistakes last time. That should not repeat. For that reason, you will do the comparison. Or as last time, in this place, with this person, I got so much business, or in this place I got so much profits, in this area we got for the less price, like that you can do the comparison. Got it? Now what are the characteristics? Not only these, there are so many kind of characteristics, different books mentioned in different way. So, but the main concept will be the same. Maybe side heading might be differing, the concept will be almost same. Okay, the characteristics are reliability, relevance, classified data, understandability and comparability. Got it? All of you clear with these characteristics? Next, we will be discussing about branches of business. That means what are the types of, branches of accounts, not business. Branches of accounts we are learning now. There are different types of accounts we have. Since you are in class 11 and class 12, PUC 1 and PUC 2. You will be learning financial accounting. Financial accounting only, not more than that. Okay. So, cost accounting, management accounting, you just know the meaning, that much is enough for you. What are the branches of accounting? 2 mark question or 1 mark question will come. That time you can mention those names. Got it? Okay. Financial accounting we are learning in these 2 years. What is the meaning of financial accounting is? In this we are discussing about the finance more and more. Got it? Cost accounting. Cost accounting, it is very interesting topic. In the degree, once you move on, you will be learning those cost accounting concept. What is cost accounting? If you take a pen, we are writing with pen every day. How do they fix the price? 10 rupees, 15 rupees. How do they fix the price? That you will be learning from cost accounting. Okay. How do you buy the material? How do they manufacture the material? Why manufacturing? How do they fix the prices? What they do with the scrap, what is scrap, everything you will be learning from cost accounting. Okay, now how to learn, how to manufacture, how to fix the prices, you learn in cost accounting. Financial accounting, we learn about total finance. Then what is management accounting? What is the use of management accounting? What is the meaning of management accounting? Management accounting, to take the decisions, to take the position of the company. Okay. Comparisons, that everything will be done in the management accounting. Okay, these are the different branches of accounting. So in this video you are learning, first you learn the definition, and after that you learn the characteristics, and then you learn the branches. All of you first copy this one, then we'll move on to the objectives, then we can go to the next video. Okay, first please copy this one. Yes. Why we are doing the business? Anyone in lakhs, thousands, crores, whatever amount they spend, let them spend. But why they are doing the business? To earn the profits, right? Not to get the losses. So to know whether you are in profits or you are in losses. How do you know profit or losses? That we will be knowing in the next steps that I will explain you. Next, to know the sources of revenues and expenditure. From where you are getting good profits, where you are spending more, everything you will be knowing from the accounts. How will you know from the accounts? Because they will be having the record of all the transactions. When they maintain that one, every month you will be finding what is your data, what happened in this month, expenses are more. Then you will find out where that expenses are more, where you spent more, or in one particular month your revenue is more, who has given you that much of revenue, in which source you have received that revenue, that and all you will be knowing from these accounts only. Okay. Next, to ascertain the financial position of the business. What is this financial position? Financial position in the sense to know what is the wealth of the business. What is the difference between wealth and profit? Profit in the sense when your expenses are less than your incomes or your revenues, then you can call it as profit. Your expenses are more than your incomes, then it will be treated as loss. But this financial position, that means the wealth in the sense, what is the properties your business earned while doing the business, that you will be showing here. Okay. Not only that, when any bank wanted to give you the loan, how they will give you the loan? First they have to see your accounting transactions, right? Whether already if you are in the losses, why they will be giving you the loan? Because there is no chance for you to return that money. So that time they will not give you the loan. So to know that one, sometimes you may be having some court cases or something, that time it will be showing as witness, as a proof. These accounts will be helping you, or some of them wanted to invest in your business, then they have to see the last 3-4 years of balance sheets. Then they will decide whether they have to invest in the business or not. So with this, we have completed all the topics. In the next video, we will be knowing what are the basic terms. What are the basic terms? Generally, we will be using money, right? We use the word money, but in accounts, we call it as cash. What will you say? I bought this pen. Do you ever say I purchased this pen? You don't use that word, right? Bought is the general word. Purchase is the accounting word. So what are the basic accounting terms that we will be learning in the next videos? It may take 2 videos. You just have little patience until we enter to the actual accounting problems. Okay, till that time it will be a little bit theory only. Have patience and learn. And if you people understood, please share this to more and more students. Okay, thank you very much. Bye-bye.